इलेक्स। सो बिफोर लर्निंग अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स, लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज फ्लक्स, व्हाट डू मीन बाय फ्लक्स इन डे टू डे लाइफ। सो जनरली अ फ्लक्स इज डिफाइंड एज द नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट पासिंग थ्रू ए गिवन एरिया। ऑलवेज फ्लक्स इज ऑलवेज एसोसिएटेड विथ एन एरिया एंड इट इज डिफाइंड एज द नंबर ऑफ फ्लक्स गिवन इन दिस एरिया। इफ थ्री नंबर ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट्स आर पासिंग थ्रू दिस गिवन एरिया देन फ्लक्स विल बी थ्री। ओके, सो लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड दिस विथ अ ब्यूटिफुल एग्जाम्पल्स। देर सपोज देर इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ फिशेस which is coming from right to left, and suppose there is a hungry shark which want to eat these fishes as much as possible. So in first case it is coming at some angle, in second case it is coming exactly opposite to the small fishes, and in third case it is coming perpendicular to the small fishes. Then flux will be given as, or flux will be defined as the number of small fishes that will be entering into its mouth. Okay, this, suppose this is an area. So it will be given as, defined as the number of small fishes that will be entering into its area. Then answer me in this comment section that in which case, or which fish, which in which case the shark will eat more number of fishes, whether it is in case 3, whether it is in case 2, or whether it is in case 1. Okay, so obviously your answer will be the case 2, because in these cases more area are available for the small fishes to enter into the mouth, right? So more area will be available. So, and now if I define this flux as phi, okay, if I symbolize it with phi, then phi will be maximum in case 3. So, and it will be minimum in which case? It will be minimum in case 3, right? Sorry, it will be maximum in case 2 and it will be minimum in case 3, because no area is available for entering into the shark, because shark the small fishes will be and go this side and shark will be will move this side, so no fishes will enter into its mouth. That's why flux in this case is zero. Okay, so flux will be minimum in this cases. So this, in which factor does this shark flux will depend upon? This flux will depend upon velocity of this shark fishes. Okay, if more if the shark fishes has more velocity, then more number of small fishes will be entering into its mouth. And second thing, it will depend upon the area of this opening, right? This area, if this area will be wider, then more number of fishes will be entering. If this area will be lesser, then less number of fishes will be entering, right? So exactly in the electric flux will be defined as the velocity will be replaced by electric field. If more electric field is entering into its area, okay, and this, and there is area given by there will be area associated with this flux, which will be already given in the questions. Then this area, the number of electric field, electric flux entering into this area, the electric field lines of force entering into this area will be called electric field. So phi will be equal to E dot A, whereas in previous case or in mechanics it was V dot A. Do you remember this picture? Well, this is a picture of a coronavirus which is making all the damage throughout the world, right? So it is pretty much similar with the electric lines of force. Generally, electric lines of force is the path followed by a positive charge when put near any other charges, right? So exactly, suppose this, if this was, this is a positive charge, then if you put another positive charge, then this move this way, this move this way. Here if you put, it will move in this way. Here if you put, it will this move in this way. So the path followed by a positive charge under the influence of another charge is called electric lines of force. So here also, if you put a positive charge over here, this will move in this way. If you put a positive charge over here, this will move this way. If you put a charge here, it will move in this way. If you charge here, it will move in this way. So all these paths, so the lines of force, these are the lines of force, clear? So lines of force is given by or defined by path followed by unit positive charge when put under the influence of another charges, right? So then what do you mean by flux? We have already mentioned that flux is a number of object passing through a given area. So here object is your lines of force and the area is already given to you. If this area, if lines of force are passing perpendicularly to an area, then it will be given as the electric flux. So electric flux is defined as the number of lines of force passing through a given area perpendicularly. Remember the term perpendicularly, because when the area does not hit the area, when the lines of force perpendicularly, then the flux will be zero. Suppose this is, instead of in this way, if it is kept parallel to this line, that means the area, suppose this area would be, if this area would be this way, then no flux will be, and no electric lines will pass through this line, okay, perpendicularly, so the flux will be zero, right? So the flux has some connection with the density of the flow, okay. If there are more number of flux, more number of lines of force, then we call that as the more number of fluxes are there. Here in this case, it has a 3 lines of force, it has a 6 lines of force. That's why flux is maximum in this case. Here also, the line, it is coming at some angle with the forces, then some part of it is perpendicular. That's why it is coming, the flux in this case is low and flux in this case is higher. Here area is lesser, that's why less number of electric flux are passing. Here area is bigger, that's why more number of fluxes are there. Right, so there is a combination of flux and area, the number of lines of force. Then here in this cases, it is coming perpendicular. Generally flux is defined as I said, that E dot A, okay, the area, that means E A cos theta. Whenever you say A cos A B, A dot B, then it is A B cos theta, and when I say E dot A, then it is E A cos theta. Here theta is the angle between electric field and area vector. So generally electric field has the same direction as the lines of forces. So here in this case, it is the direction of the electric flux, and the area of a given direction of a given area is always given by taking it perpendicular to this area. Suppose this is a plane, then if you take a perpendicular to the plane, then this will be given by the area of this plane. Right, so in this case also, if you take the any direction perpendicular to this plane, then it is called the area direction of this plane, okay. Here, so direction of this plane is this way, and direction of the electric field is this way. So note it that both directions are same, that's why angle between them is zero, right, or 180 degree. That's why angle between them, here theta is equal to zero, so phi is equal to e dot a, right, E dot A. But here in this case, area theta is not 0, that's why cos theta is not exactly equal to 1. So cos theta will be something less than 1, that's why the final flux will be less than E dot A, okay. So flux is maximum in case of this picture. So if it is A and it is the case of B, then flux in case of the B has more magnitude than flux in case of the A, right? So then let's find the connection between electric flux and electric field, okay. Let's find the connection. So we already said that there is a positive charge always radiates some. If you have a positive charge, then you have some electric lines of force as shown in this figure here. So then comes the question, then how many lines of force does this electric charge radiate, okay. If you have a charge, then how many flux does the electric charge radiate? Then there is a simple answer to this one. So it is a basic assumption that if you have a charge of unit 1 coulomb of charges, that means unit positive charges, then it generally emits radiates 1 by epsilon 0 amount of electric flux, okay. Then if value of the epsilon 0 is generally 8.85 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 12, okay, it is in the SI unit. So 1 by epsilon 0 is generally 1 by 8.5 multiplied by 10 to the power 1 by 10 to the power minus 12. So 10 to the 1 by 10 to the power minus 12 is generally 10 to the power 12, okay. Then this much number of electric flux is radiated by the electric lines of the electric charge. 1 coulomb of electric charge will radiate this number of electric flux, okay. Then 2 coulomb of charges will obviously radiate how much? If 1 coulomb charge radiate 1 by epsilon 0, 2 coulomb charge will be replaced by, if I double this charge, the lines of force will be doubled, so it will be radiate 2 into 1 by epsilon 0. If 3 coulomb charge I replaced it, then it will be 3 into 1 by epsilon 0. Okay, now if I put a q coulomb charge over here, then the total number of electric flux will be q into 1 by epsilon 0. Okay, so that's what I mean. Then the total lines of force, if I put a q amount of charges, here suppose it is q amount of charges, then total lines of force will be q into 1 by epsilon 0, and that is equal to q by epsilon 0. Now, in order to catch all these lines of forces, perpendicularly, because I defined flux as lines of force passing through the surface perpendicularly, so I have to choose a surface which is perpendicular to all these lines of forces. So I have to smartly choose a surface in which the all the lines of forces which pass this perpendicularly. Here this case it will pass perpendicularly. So only geometric figure that encloses, that satisfy this picture, that all the lines of forces, whether it is in this direction, so to satisfy this condition, one physical or one geometrical picture is possible, that is called sphere, right? That is called a spherical object. If I put a spherical object over here, then for all the lines of forces, the area vector will be parallel to the lines of forces, okay, will be perpendicular to the lines of forces, sorry. So here in this case, if this is the surface, then it is moved here perpendicularly. Here also it is moved perpendicularly. Here also it passes perpendicularly. So all these cases, this line will passes perpendicularly. That's why we choose a spherical surface, right? So that all the lines of force will penetrate or move pass through the surface perpendicularly. So suppose this area, suppose this radius of this surface or sphere is R. So whenever you have a sphere, then you will definitely called a parameter which is radius. Okay, you recognize that surface or sphere with a radius. Suppose that radius is R, then the surface area will be how much? 4 pi R square, right? The surface area will be 4 pi R square. So how many number lines of forces are there? Q by epsilon number of lines of forces are there. How much area is there? 4 pi R square area is there, right? So suppose, for example, if you have a 400 lines of force passing through a 40 meter square area. Suppose you have 400 lines of forces passing through a 40 meter square area. Then if I ask you the question that if I take 1 meter square, then how much area will be, how much lines of forces pass through that? Okay, I have to calculate the number of lines of force passing through a unit area. Okay, that's why 1 meter square. Then you will say that it will be 400 divided by 40, which is equal to 10, right? So 10 lines of forces will pass through a given 1 meter square area. Okay, so here in this cases it is called line density. So number of line passing through a given area is called line density. If I same cases I choose here, then the line density will be number of lines of forces, that is 400 previously, number of lines of forces or lines of forces LOF, I have represented it, so divided by total area of the surface. Okay, for 4 pi r square it was q by epsilon amount of charges. For 1 meter square, how much lines of forces are there? It will be given by q over epsilon 0 divided by total area. Okay, so it will be q by epsilon 0 divided by 1 by 4 pi square. So q is in the numerator, so it is in numerator. Okay, epsilon 0 is the denominator, then 4 pi. Okay, I inserted this epsilon 0 over here, then r square. So it is q divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 r square. If I organize this way a little bit, then I will have 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0, then q divided by r square. Okay, have you seen this formula earlier? Previously, you have already known this, the definition of electric field, right? So electric field E is equal to generally 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r square. It is defined as the force for unit area, for unit charge. So it is electric field, right? So the electric field is equal to what? Density of the forces, density of the lines of forces. So density of the lines of forces is equal to electric field. That's the relation between electric field and density of lines of forces. Now there is a famous law which is called Gauss law. Okay, there is a famous law which is Gauss law. So it generally tell the simple story. If as I have already told you what the Gauss law is, you have already known that I have already said that one charge gives you 1 coulomb of charge gives you 1/ε0 number of lines of force. Two coulomb charge gives you 2 × 1/ε0 number of lines of force, and q coulomb charge gives you q/ε0 lines of force. That means if 2 increases, then lines of force increases. If charge increases, then also lines of force increases. This is the charge, this is the lines of force. That's why if I double the charge, then lines of force will be double here in this case. For 1 coulomb of charge, it was 1/ε0. For 2 coulomb of charge, it will be 2 × 1/ε0. That's why the number of lines of force increases with the electric charge, right? So that is the Gauss law. So that is the Gauss law. It says that electric flux linked with the surface, that means electric flux is the number of lines of force passing through that area, a specific area. It is associated with area. That area is called Gaussian surface. Okay, so electric flux linked with a surface is directly proportional to the amount of charges enclosed within it. That means here a Gaussian surface is there. That means a closed Gaussian surface is a closed surface, right? The Gaussian surface is a closed surface. It is an imaginary surface that you imagine physically. So it is a closed surface, whether it may be spherical, okay, it may be cylindrical, it may be cubical. Okay, so many type of surface are there, closed surface are there. So whatever it may be, but when you put a lines of charge inside it, okay, then electric flux will be, electric lines of force will pass through it. So that electric flux will pass through the surface, which you call Gaussian surface. Then the number of lines of force passing through this area will be called what? Electric flux. And this flux is directly related. This, that means this lines of force passing through perpendicularly through this surface is directly proportional to the amount of charges inside this surface. Okay, that means if you put more charges inside it, then more number of flux or more number of lines of force will penetrate through this area or Gaussian surface, right? That is the case. So here mathematically, if we say it is represented by phi, okay, electric flux is represented by phi, it is directly proportional to the q, amount of charges that you have. Then if you, something is proportional to another thing, then when we eliminate this proportionality constant and make a equal sign, then I have to multiply simply a constant, and that's that constant here in this case is 1/ε0. It is a proportionality constant, where ε0 is the permittivity of the absolute free space, right? So then this q will be equal to phi will be equal to q enclosed. Here I word mention the word enclosed. Here enclosed means the total number of charges inside this Gaussian surface. Okay, so if I put a Gauss of charge over here, then this does not make any impact to the lines of force flux of this charges. So all the charges that I take into consideration is the charges enclosed within this Gaussian surface. That means charges within this Gaussian surface. Okay, so if I put a charge over here, then I will consider it. Then if I put a charge outside this surface, then I do not mention or do not calculate that charges or electric flux, right? So that's why the term enclosed, q enclosed means charge enclosed within the Gaussian surface, not outside the Gaussian surface, right? That's all for today. If you enjoy this video, then hit the like button and subscribe this channel. And if you want to join with me, if you want to answer all my MCQ, then join me with the Telegram channel. I have already given the link in the description box. Here we shall discuss all the MCQ.